Okay, let's look at a couple more operators. I'm going to switch over and use the Mongo shell for some of this. This is a console application that ships with the database, and it provides a great interface for exploring MongoDB's query language. So the first thing that I need to do is switch into the right database, which I've already done here with use examples. Now I'm just going to do a find against the whole collection. We see a whole bunch of documents scroll by. Okay, so as we've discussed, some documents will contain fields that others do not. In our cities collection, for many cities, especially those that are less important or simply smaller, much of the detail is missing. For example, a small town in the U.S. state of Iowa, where I used to live, is going to have much less detail than, say, Berlin, London, or other major cities. MongoDB allows you to query based on the structure of information that's in the documents, as well as their values. So let's take a look at an example. So I happen to know that relatively few documents have a field for government type. It's useful to know what type of government a particular city has, but it's only the larger cities that tend to have this field. MongoDB provides an operator called exists that allows us to retrieve documents based on whether or not documents contain a particular field. And the value for exists is whether we want documents that contain the field or those that don't. In this case, I want to find documents that do have a government type field. Oh, and you see what happened there is I forgot to close the query document. So let's go back and do that. And there we go. And let's do a count here. And of the 20,000 documents in this collection, a relatively small number contain this field. We can do the inverse query and see we get a much larger number. Let's take a look at one of these documents. Here I'm going to use pretty to make it more human readable. Okay, so let's go back to the documents that actually contain this field. And again, we'll make them pretty. Okay, so this happens to be the city of Lansing, Michigan. And you can see there's quite a bit of detail here. Okay, now what we can do is contrast this with documents that don't have this field. And it just happens to be the case that this document is conveniently, for example purposes, much more sparse. So the exists operator allows us to do queries and ask some questions about the structure of a document.